Attila, I'm at the mountain.
What do you see?
Just a whole lot of climbing.
I did warn you.
Not now, Attila. One wrong move and I'm a dead man.
But do you see anything?
Later, man. Seriously. Yeah. Okay, I'm at the top. It's an awesome view.
Let's get to work then, Mr. Crane.
There's a painting of a bloody blade on one of the monoliths.
Anything else? A mask, perhaps?
No. Should I be looking for a mask?
With the utmost diligence, Mr. Crane. This is very important.
Attila, I found this hole with, I don't know, I guess there are offerings inside it. And there's a mask in here, too.
Is it red? If it's red, take it with you. Be careful with it.
Yeah, it's red. Should I take anything else? There's a lot of stuff in here.
No, that should be enough. I think you can come back now, Mr. Crane.
Yeah.
I'm closing up shop and moving somewhere else. Last chance to get a great deal.
Here's your mask, Attila. I don't know if it's gonna help with anything.
Listen, the mother's obsessed with this prophecy. When the world is ravaged by plague, when darkness devours the earth, when men are as beasts to one another, when humanity shall be struck by corruption of both flesh and soul, then shall be revealed one man who, through an act of ultimate sacrifice, shall accept the mercy of the light. And the God of the Sun shall be revealed through him, and through him will he speak. And his voice shall be the light and the healing. And he shall pass through the gates of death, so that he may bring new life. On every remaining painting, the God of the Sun, or a priest attempting to summon him, wears a mask like that one. So, yes, Mr. Crane, I believe you've helped me plenty.
You need anything else?
Only time and peace. I have to write everything down. I'll let the Acolytes know that you've helped me. Thank you, Mr. Crane. I'll call you the moment I'm done.
See you tomorrow, then.
You promise? All right. I'll be waiting for you.